Yes, a very good morning. So we were discussing chapter number 14, mean of grouped data, right? I told you about how to find mean using direct method. Let us start with the next method. Let us consider a simple data, 10 to 20, 20 to 30, 30 to 40. These are the marks and number of students. They are given to be 2, 3, 4, 5. I'm just taking the simple data to explain the mean through assumed mean method that is there in our syllabus. So number of anything, you will regard it as FIs. We already know that number of anything, we will regard it to be FIs, right? So next column, which we have to make, let us firstly discuss it. What is the formula of mean? When I'm writing X bar, it means mean. It is the notation for mean, right? So this is equal to A plus sigma Fi Di over sigma Fi. So the formula of the mean, it is little different than that of we did in case of direct method. See, here I'm writing A, but for what A stands for? A will be assumed mean. Last time we did Fi Xi, I told you what is Fi Xi. When Fi and Xi, we are multiplying them, we are making a column Fi Xi and adding them gives us sigma Fi Xi. Similarly, what is Fi Di? What is Di? Di are deviations. Deviations of all Xi's from assumed mean. अभी जैसे मैं इसको अप्लाई करूंगी क्वेश्चन में देन इट विल बी बेटर द पिक्चर विल बी क्लियर टू यू इन अ बेटर वे. व्हाट इज डीआई? डीआई इज डेविएशन ऑफ एक्सआई फ्रॉम मीन. डीआई इज डेविएशन ऑफ एक्सआई फ्रॉम मीन, राइट? सो लेट अस सी दैट व्हाट डीआई विल, हाउ डीआई विल फॉर्म यूजिंग दिस डाटा. First of all, you need Xi. Whatever formula you are using, whether you are using the direct method to find out mean or you are using assumed mean method, always you have to create one column and that column is known as Xi's. I told you how to find Xi. Xi is midpoint of this interval. That means class marks of the intervals. That is 0 plus 10, 5, 10 by 2. अब 10-10 का डिफरेंस है, यू नो नीड टू फाइंड फॉर एवरी इंटरवल, जस्ट गो विद द डिफरेंस क्लास साइज, ऐड द क्लास साइज इन द प्रीवियस वन, यू विल गेट द नेक्स्ट क्लास मार्क. दिस इज 5, नेक्स्ट विल बी 15, फर्दर नेक्स्ट विल बी 25 एंड द फर्दर नेक्स्ट विल बी से इट बी 35. लेट मी टेक वन मोर कॉलम बिकॉज आई वॉन्ट टू एक्सप्लेन दैट हाउ वी कैन टेक इट. दिस इज 45. So these are the Xi's. So I told you that you have to take A as assumed mean. And from where this A will come, let me tell you. Just a minute, wait. So I was telling you that from here this A, that means assumed mean will be taken. All these Xi's which are formed in front of you, out of this one value will be taken as assumed mean. इनमें से जो एक value है, उसको हम assumed mean मानेंगे. Now the question is, which value is to be taken as assumed mean? I am taking here even a odd number of you can say intervals, just to explain how to take assumed mean in a better way. When the number of observations are even, then what you have to do, leave half of the observation low and half of the observation above, and the middle one will be assumed mean, right here A. And had it been even number of intervals, agar intervals even hote hamare paas, then how to take the assumed mean out of the values? Then out of the middle two, you can take any. Jaise ki agar hamare paas 4 hote, to hum दोनों में से 15 और 25 में से किसी को भी assumed mean ले सकते हैं. So the better way to take the assumed mean in case of you can say odd number of intervals, keep half of the values above, and by keeping half of the value below, you can take the center one to be the assumed mean. Right, now we want to obtain one column, as our formula is saying. Di is our deviations of all the xi's from assumed mean. Matlab deviation means difference. जितने भी आपके xi's हैं उनमें उनको जब उनमें से जब assumed mean हम minus करते हैं तो that forms di. Di is equal to xi minus a. So we are using it here, xi minus a. First xi is 5 and you will subtract 25, subtract it from 25, this will be minus 20. Then 15 minus 25 will be minus 10, right? So there will come a place when deviation will come 0, as 25 assumed mean minus 25 will give you 0. Then 35 minus 10 will give you 10, and then 45 minus 25, that will be 20. You always see that whenever you are finding the deviations, assumed mean jahan se aapne choose kiya hai, uske niche wahi values positive sign ke saath, aur uske upar wahi value negative sign ke saath. Sometimes upar wali value positive ke saath, niche wali values ne. Same values hoengi with opposite signs. So these are deviations, that means xi minus a. Right, Anshika, please send me the attendance regularly. I'm telling you again, your attendance is getting short because you are not attending the lectures regularly. Very bad on your part. So this is di. So now xi, ye hamara di ka column ban gaya, jiska matlab hai ki sare xi's a mein se subtract hote jayenge, and we will form di in this way. Now the thing is, how to find fi di? Very easy. As we have find out fi xi, same we will find out FIDI. FIDI means you will multiply these FIs, the values of DIs you are getting. This is minus 40, minus 30, 0, 50, and then 20. 50, 20, iski value ko hum thoda change karte hain, 2 le lete hain. 40. ये तो उतना ही रहेगा, 20 ही, ये 40 बन जाएगा, ठीक है? So let us find sigma FIDI. Sigma का मतलब मैंने आपको बताया था उस दिन, ये summation FIDI. Summation FIDI means जितने आपके पास FIDIs हैं सबको आपने add up कर देना है. अब आपको पता है आपने integers को add करना सीखा था, you know how to add the integers. पहले हम positive वाले को add कर लेते हैं, फिर negative वालों को add कर लेते हैं, फिर दोनों का आपस में जो relation बनता है उस हिसाब से. Let us add these two positive. This is 90 minus minus plus. This is minus 70. Negative number, that means above 0, we are getting the sum to be minus 70, and below 0, we are getting the sum to be 90. This is 90, this is minus 70, and they all are to be added. So, aap dekho, 90 plus minus 70, that is 90 minus 70, it will give you 20. So, FIDI in all, it comes out to be 20. So now you can replace all the values in the formula and you can reach to the required result. That means you can reach to the mean of the data. Assumed mean we are taking to be 25. FIDI comes out to be 20, and sigma FI, we haven't find it. Sigma FI, this is equal to 16. This is 16. So this will be 420 upon 60. This is 105 upon 4. This is called assumed mean method of finding out the mean of the given data. So both the you can say formulas I have discussed. One is the direct method of finding out the mean. Another is the assumed mean method of finding out the mean. So let us start with the exercise. Exercise 14.1. Open up your books at exercise. Now, some of the students, they are getting confused, or you can say they are double-minded that which formula is to use and which formula is to be applied in a particular question. अदर सी इफ इट इज रिटन दैट फाइंड द मीन यूजिंग डायरेक्ट मेथड, अगर तो पेपर में मेंशन है कि आपने डायरेक्ट मेथड से निकालना है, देन यू हैव टू गो विद दैट मेथड ओनली. इफ इट इज रिटन दैट फाइंड द मीन यूजिंग अज्यूम्ड मीन मेथड, देन अकॉर्डिंगली यू हैव टू डील इट विद अज्यूम्ड मीन मेथड. बट इफ नो मेथड इज मेंशन, देन इफ द इंटरवल्स वैल्यू आर यू कैन से लार्जर, then you go with assumed mean value. If the intervals values they are smaller, then direct method can also be applied, right? चलिए, so I am taking its सारे questions एक जैसे हैं. Third question different है. पहले मैं आपको इसमें से दो questions करवाऊंगी and two you have to do as homework. One you will do with the direct method, another you will do with the assumed mean method. I am teaching firstly question number second. Let us start with the second question of exercise 14.1. Question number second. Daily wages in rupees, then number of workers. Daily wages in rupees, then number of workers. मैं assumed mean method लगाऊंगी यहां पे. Number of workers, this is 12, 14, 8, 6 and 10. Most of the students, they are thinking of this thing that FI is F kind, frequency kind. We know that number of anything is FI, frequency is number of observation. So number of workers, we will regard it to be FI. So first of all, you need to obtain one column that is called xi's. Xi's are the mid values of the intervals. जो xi's होती हैं, वो intervals की mid values हैं. तो हम सबसे पहले यहाँ पे जो है वो xi's को निकालने की कोशिश करेंगे. That what are xi's? I already told you that xi's are the mid values of the intervals. चलिए. So 100 plus 120, 200 divided by 2. Sorry, 100 plus 120, 220 divided by 2, that means 110. Now see the difference is of 20. So you can go accordingly. 130, 150, 170 and 190. 20 is the size of the interval. Size of the interval is upper value, upper limit minus the lower limit, and that will give you 20. So 20 ke accordingly, I'm getting the xi's accordingly. Same. Now, the third column that we want to make, that is DI. DI is XI minus A. So, assumed mean you have to choose. I'm taking assumed mean to be 150, leaving half values above it and half values below it. So, minus kare, 110 minus 150, this will be minus 40, this will be minus 20, this will be 0, this will be 20, and this will be 40. These are the deviations. ये हमारी deviations हैं, right? Now we have to make the column FIDI. FIDI means this FI, they are going to multiply with this DI. 12 into minus 40, calculation करना साथ साथ, minus 480, minus 280, 0, 120 and 400. This is the column of FIDI. Now I will calculate sigma fi di. This is sigma fi di, one thing. Another thing I need to calculate is sigma fi. So all fi's are to be added. This is 26 plus 8, 34 plus 6, 40 plus 10, 50. Sigma fi. And sigma fi di, first of all, these are to be calculated. This is equal to 520 and this is minus 760. Now these two are to be solved, plus minus minus 760 minus 520. This will give you minus 240. So when you are solving these two, you are getting it to be minus 420. This is your sigma Fi Di. Oh, sorry, 240. Minus 240 comes out to be sigma Fi Di. Calculations aasa check karte rehna. Right? So this is the formula. It's already been written that X bar, that means mean, X bar stands for mean. Mean is equal to A plus sigma Fi Di over sigma Fi. So let us replace the values. Assumed mean, we have taken it to be 150 plus sigma Fi Di. Some of the students, they are thinking that sigma Fi Di, it is coming it as a negative number, so it is wrong. No, it's nothing is wrong in this. It can be a negative number. Plus sigma Fi Di minus 240 and sigma Fi, you can see better, that is 50. 0, 0 get cancelled. Kabhi bhi na yahan pe divide mat karo. LCM leke uske baad divide karo. That is a better way. Because kabhi kabhi yahan pe proper jo hai division nahi hoti, to decimal mein answer thoda problem create karta hai. So this is 150 plus minus minus 25 upon 4. Let us take LCM. This is 750 minus 24 upon 5. So this will be 726 upon 5. Now do the division. Divide zarur karke aana hai jab bhi aisi koi division aapke samne aa jaye. So this will be 145.2 is the answer. Kisi na kisi interval ke beech mein aapki jo mean ki value hai aapko lie karti hui mil gayi. So this is 145.2. So this is how to find a mean using assumed mean method, right? So I'm now teaching question number third of 14.1. Exercise 14.1, question number third. Let us start with third question. Read out the statement. There is little difference than that of the previous question and in this question. See, you are given the data which is showing the daily pocket allowance of the children of a locality. The mean pocket allowance is rupees 18. Find the missing frequency F. This time mean is available to us and we want to find the missing frequency. हमें missing frequency जो है वो find करनी है. और मीन हमारे पास गिवन. चलिए लेट अस स्टार्ट. फर्स्ट इज डेली पॉकेट अलाउंस इन रुपीस. दिस इज गिवन टू बी 11 टू 13, 13 टू 15, 15 टू 17, 17 टू 19, 19 टू 21, 21 टू 23 एंड 23 to 25. This is your daily pocket allowance. It is given to be this. And next column is number of children. Obviously, number of anything we regard it to be frequency. Number of children. I am taking it to be Fi, and it is given to be 7, 6, 9, 13, and this is the missing frequency F. And that is 5 and 4. Keep one thing in your mind, whether the calculations are difficult or easy, when the missing frequencies are to be find out, better to go with the direct formula of finding out the mean. That will help you to crack the things properly. So first of all, let us obtain xi. Xi's are obtained by finding out the midpoint of the interval. 11 plus 13, this is 24 upon 2, that is 12. 2, 2 ka difference hai, so this is 14, then 16, then 18, then 20, 22, 24. These are going to be your xi's, right? So directly get it by, I am telling you that by direct method we are going to find it. So let us obtain Fi Xi. Multiply these two. This will be 84. 144. Calculation check karte rehna. Now 20 and F. Unlike terms, 20F. Now, what you need to find? You need to find sigma Fi and sigma Fi Xi as you're applying direct method of finding out the mean. So, one thing that the students do wrongly in such kind of question, sigma Fi means adding all these Fi's. And when you are adding Fi's, keep one thing in mind, only the like terms are to be added. What it means? That frequencies, when we are adding them, F jo hai, wo in sab mein add nahi hoega. It is unlike term. Pehle in sab ko add kar lo, 13 plus 9, 22 plus 13, 35, 35 plus 9, 44 and plus F. Unlike term jo hai, wo hum 44 mein add nahi kar sakte, because 44 and F are unlike. So I'm writing it to be 44 plus F. Algebra mein, we learned that only the like terms are to be added. Now, these all will be added, but this we are not going to add in that. That is unlike. So, hum add karte hain inko 6, 10, 14, 18, plus 4, 22. ध्यान से देखो कैलकुलेशंस आर दे ओके कैलकुलेशन साथ साथ चेक करते जाओ नाइन फिफ्टी टू प्लस ट्वेंटी एफ किसी को थोड़ा भी लगता है कि कहीं कैलकुलेशन में कोई गड़बड़ हो रही है तो प्लीज एट द सेम टाइम टेल मी सो दैट वी कैन डू इट अकॉर्डिंगली सो दिस इज एफ आई एक्स आई सो मीन इज इक्वल टू sigma Fi Xi upon sigma Fi. So this time mean of the data, it is given to you and that is given to be 18. Put the values 18, sigma Fi Xi 952 plus 20 F, sigma Fi 44 plus F. So this way you are getting an equation in terms of F from which F can be evaluated. Cross multiplying. 18 multiply 44 plus F. This is equal to 952 plus 20 F. The major mistake students do here that they write it like this. 18 multiply. That means they multiply 18 by this only. No, it is to be written in the bracket. Now let us open the bracket. Plus 18 F. This is equal to 952 plus 20 F. नेगेटिव कैसे आ रहा है एफ की वैल्यू नेगेटिव फ्रीक्वेंसी तो कभी नेगेटिव हो ही नहीं सकती फ्रीक्वेंसी कांट बी नेगेटिव 20 आंसर आ रहा है कहीं कोई गड़बड़ हुई बिकॉज ये उधर जाके पॉजिटिव बनेगा ये इधर आके नेगेटिव बनेगा एक बार कैलकुलेशन चेक करो यस अंशिका
मैम माइट बी सिग्मा एफ एक्स आई ठीक नहीं है मैम 952 की जगह 752 आना चाहिए शायद
एक मिनट मुझे देखने दे ओहो जो गलती मैं आपको करने से रोक रही थी वही गलती मैं खुद कर गई व्हेन आई एम एडिंग दिस मैंने ये वाला टू भी ऐड कर दिया 20F वाला ठीक है दिस इज 752 मुझे देखो एकदम से आइडिया हुआ कि आंसर गलत आएगा क्योंकि फ्रीक्वेंसी मेरी नेगेटिव आ रही थी और नंबर ऑफ एनीथिंग कांट बी नेगेटिव एफ कभी नेगेटिव नहीं हो सकता दैट्स व्हाई द वे दिस इज द वे आई एम फाइंडिंग माय मिस्टेक कलेक्टिंग द लाइक टर्म्स यू आर गेटिंग 18F माइनस 20F इज इक्वल टू 752 माइनस 792 सो दिस विल बी माइनस 2F इज इक्वल टू 0 4 minus 40, minus minus get cancelled. F is 40 upon 2, so F comes out to be 20. So this is a missing frequency. Or if you want to check whether your answer is okay, जैसे तो वहां पे सिग्मा एफ पूरा दिया नहीं हुआ, अदरवाइज जहां पे दो फ्रीक्वेंसीज होती है वहां पे सिग्मा एफ भी दिया होता है और हम अपनी डाटा की अपने आंसर्स को वेरीफाई कर सकते हैं. एनी हाउ सो यू नो फ्रॉम टुडे योर टेस्ट आर गोइंग टू बी स्टार्टेड, सो बी वेरी सिंसियर, शो योर सिंसियरिटी टुवर्ड्स दैट ऑल्सो, बिकॉज योर टेस्ट दे आर टू बी चेक्ड, दे आर टेस्ट रिकॉर्ड इज टू बी मेंटेन्ड, दैट इज टू बी टोल्ड टू योर पेरेंट्स आफ्टरवर्ड्स व्हेन एवर स्कूल विल बी ओपन. So otherwise we can tell your parents by calling them also. So the report will be sent to your parents side by side. So please be very careful in attempting your test. Be honest in attempting your test and don't miss your test at any cost. Right? चलिए board class है बच्चे. So many strategies we people are making so that आपको ये याद रहे कि हमारी board class है and we have to be regular in the classes and we have to show our proper sincerity. Only then the outcome can be there if you are with us, right? So better है. चलिए तो ये हमारी first exercise, this is related to the mean of the data and I am giving you the two parts to do as homework. Question number 4th you will do. चलो three parts करो. Question number 4, missing frequency का और कोई है नहीं. Question number 7. Question number 4, question number 7 and question number 8. These three questions you will do on your homework notebook. Very soon I will tell you that you have to send your holidays homework also. So prepare with that also. Hope you did it in the holidays only and will not be in a hurry when it will be announced in the class. Right? चलिए सो दिस इज ऑल अबाउट मीन. फर्स्ट मेजर ऑफ सेंट्रल टेंडेंसी, टू मेथड्स वी हैव डिस्कस्ड. वन इज अ डायरेक्ट मेथड ऑफ फाइंडिंग आउट द मीन, अनदर इज द अज्यूम्ड मीन मेथड ऑफ फाइंडिंग आउट द मीन. चलिए लेट अस स्टार्ट विद द नेक्स्ट मेजर ऑफ सेंट्रल टेंडेंसी, दैट इज मीडियन. Median is average. Mean means average. It gives us the average value of the data, right? About which the values are of the data, they are clustered. So what you can say about Vanshika, you also not only matlab to come in my class and to show that you are attending the classes, you have to attend all the classes. Ye Anshika, Dilpreet, so many teachers are telling me that Suryansh, Simarpreet, Dilpreet, Anshika, even Krishna ka naam bhi kuch teachers lete hain. They are not attending our classes. So this is not the way. If you will attend all the classes, only then I will mark you present. Otherwise, your attendance will be short. Chaliye. So median is that value which divides the data into two equal parts. 50% observation lies above it and 50% observations lie below it. Median is that value which divides the data into two equal parts. 50% values lie above the median value and 50% values lie below the median value. So as far as the simple data is concerned, we know that after arranging the data in ascending order and looking at n, that is number of observation which is odd here. So median is equal to value of n plus 1 by 2th observation. Yani ki isme ek add karke 2 se divide kar do. That means 5 plus 1, 6. That means third observation. Third observation is 6. इसमें तो हम orally ही median find कर लेते हैं कि half values इधर गई, half values इधर गई और जो बीच वाली value आई वो median होगी. और जब हम एक value और यहाँ पे ले आए उस केस में हम क्या करते हैं, median will be the mean of these two values. That means 6 plus 8 upon 2. That means 14 upon 2. That is equal to 7. This is the way to find out the मीन. भावना नहीं मुझे दिख रही क्लास में आज. वेयर इज भावना? भावना भी मैंने देखा है क्लासेस मिस करने लग पड़ी है. प्रीवियसली शी वाज वेरी रेगुलर इन द प्रीवियस व्हेन द ऑनलाइन क्लासेस वर देयर, बट दिस टाइम भावना यूज्ड टू मिस द क्लासेस. चलो एनी हाउ आई विल कॉल हर एंड आस्क द रीजन. So, you know, median in such cases, we have learned in 7th standard then 9th standard that median will be the mean of these two values when the data is having even number of values, and when the data is having odd number of values, then the center value will be regarded as median. Now, the question is, I told you that we are going to learn the method in which we will find the median of such kind of data. 20 to 30, 30 to 40 and so on. हमें ये सीखना चाहिए दैट हाउ टू फाइंड द मीडियन ऑफ this kind of data. Look at page number 277. Marks obtained, then number of students. अभी सबसे पहले मैं marks obtained को ascending order में लिखने जा रही हूँ. Data में whatever type is given, we least bother. We are just arranging it in ascending order. Number of students. 620 वही फ्रीक्वेंसी आपने सामने लिखनी है जो वैल्यू आप उठा रहे हो असेंडिंग ऑर्डर में अरेंज करते टाइम टोटल फ्रीक्वेंसीज इज 100 दिस इज समथिंग विच इज मिसिंग द स्टूडेंट्स दे डिडंट केयर अबाउट दिस एग्जांपल एंड नो डाउट नो क्वेश्चन ऑफ सच सॉर्ट इज गिवन इन द एक्सरसाइज में ऐसा कोई क्वेश्चन नहीं दिया हुआ This kind of question, this is only one example that you are getting. No question. Exercise mein all the question, they are related with the intervals. Chalo, anyhow, time is over. We'll continue tomorrow. So please, again and again, I'm telling you, do attend all the classes regularly. You're being bored class, your attendance matters a lot.